Hi guys, you're welcome once again to my channel where we talk all about emergency health and wellness tips. In today's video, we're going to be looking at the topic pelvic inflammatory disease or PID. And we're going to be talking about the definition, talk about the causes, talk about how you can contract it, the complications, the diagnosis, the signs and symptoms. We'll talk about how to reduce the risk of contracting it, the prevention and the treatment. Stay with me. The reproductive system is the part of the body that is involved in getting pregnant and having a baby. Pelvic inflammatory disease is an infection of a woman's reproductive organs. It is a complication often caused by some sexually transmitted diseases like gonorrhea and chlamydia. Other infections that are not sexually transmitted can also cause PID. The reproductive organs affected by pelvic inflammatory disease are the uterus, the ovaries, and the fallopian tubes. You are more likely to contract pelvic inflammatory disease if you 1. Have unprotected sex. 2. Have a sexually transmitted disease and do not get treated. 3. Have more than one sex partner. 4. Have a partner who has sex partners other than you. 5. Have had PID before. 6. Are sexually active and are age 25 or younger. 7. Doge. 8. Use an IUCD for birth control. Bacteria entering into the reproductive tract often cause pelvic inflammatory disease. These bacteria are passed from the vagina through the cervix into the uterus, fallopian tubes and the ovaries and into the pelvis. Normally, when bacteria enter the vagina, the cervix keeps them from spreading deeper to other reproductive organs. But sometimes, the cervix becomes infected by a sexually transmitted disease like chlamydia and gonorrhea. When this happens, it's less able to keep bacteria out. Untreated gonorrhea and chlamydia cause about 90% of PID cases. Other causes include childbirth, abortion, pelvic procedures, and an insertion of an intrauterine device or an IUD. Signs and symptoms of pelvic inflammatory disease: pain in your lower abdomen, fever or chills, an unusual discharge with a bad odor from your vagina, nausea and vomiting, pain and or bleeding when you have sex, burning sensation when you urinate, bleeding between periods, and irregular periods or having spotting or cramping throughout the month. Your healthcare provider can diagnose pelvic inflammatory disease through your medical history, where you are asked about your sexual activities and the symptoms you experience. Pelvic examination to examine your reproductive organs and look for signs of infection. Vaginal culture can also be done, where a sample is taken to identify the bacteria. Other tests include blood tests, urine tests to rule out urinary tract infection, ultrasound, endometrial biopsy, and laparoscopy. If you don't get treated, you may develop some complications. Some of these complications are formation of scar tissue both outside and inside the fallopian tubes that can lead to tubal blockage, ectopic pregnancy, that's pregnancy outside the womb, infertility, that's inability to get pregnant, and long-term pelvic and abdominal pain. The only way to avoid sexually transmitted disease is to not have vagina, anal or oral sex, in other words, abstinence, or use a latex condom the right way, or be in a long-term mutually monogamous relationship with a partner. Sometimes, pelvic inflammatory disease is not due to a sexually transmitted infection. It can come from normal vaginal bacteria traveling to your reproductive organs. Avoiding douching may lower the risk. Protect yourself from sexually transmitted infections that can cause pelvic inflammatory disease. Get regular checkup and seek medical help if you notice any of the signs and symptoms. When diagnosed early, pelvic inflammatory disease can be treated. However, treatment will not undo any damage that has already happened to your reproductive system. The longer you wait to get treated, the more likely it is that you will have complications from PID. Antibiotics is the treatment of choice. your partner should also get treated for their sick and yours. Otherwise, you may get PID again when you resume sex. Surgery is rare but can help in some cases. So guys, we've come to the end of this video. I hope you've learned a thing or two about pelvic inflammatory disease. If you find this helpful and useful, give me a thumbs up by clicking on the like button. Please subscribe to my channel for free by clicking on the red subscribe button. Also click on the notification bell so you'll be the first to know when I upload new videos. You can drop your comments or questions in the comment section below and I will attend to them. I remain your next door nurse and I'm just a knock away. I love you guys. Bye for now.